Welcome back. Thank you, darling Fejo, for the minute.
Yes, all right. Now we're going to take the review, the press review with René Narcisse Moto.
C'est fou l'ambiance qu'il y a sur ce plateau.
Peter Sossé. I don't know which one is the, what, which one? This one? Oh, okay.
Non, c'est celle-ci, celle-ci, celle-ci.
Oh, all right. You know, there are lots of cameras in here. Sometimes you just really get confused.
C'est vrai, en plus.
And so information is our primary objective on the show, Christian. Oui. And at 8 a.m., I think we're going to have Darling Fejo.
Oui, à 8 heures. Darling, qu'on vient de voir dans une minute il y a un instant. Mais tout de suite, nous allons bien sûr nous intéresser au contenu de la presse nationale. Alors, le premier arrêt majeur de ce programme. Maintenant, mesdames et messieurs, c'est l'occasion de rencontrer René Narcisse Moto et son acolyte.
I just wonder why they're all in
son
white.
Acolyte. Bonjour, les gars.
Good morning, Serafine. Good morning.
Vous êtes comme les twins. Hein? Vous choisissez d'être en veste noire, cravate noire, un jour vous êtes en blanc et tout. Qu'est-ce qui vous arrive? Vous voulez nous montrer quoi?
C'est une inspiration.
Inspiration, hein? Inspiration. Vous dormez ensemble?
Oh my God!
Non, parce que
that did not come out right. That did not come out right.
Bon, les gars, bon, je suppose que c'est sur WhatsApp que vous écrivez. Le matin, gars, ce matin, on se met en blanc, ok?
No, really.
C'est pas mauvais. Ah, c'est un symbiose.
They have a lot of things in common. The first of them, and the most important is that they love information, and of course, they love to update
D'accord.
their viewers.
Là, il est 7h30 maintenant. You have the floor, my dear.
Yes, Telegraph, it is time that we bring to report the papers will be giving us today. We'll begin right away with the London English Daily, the Guardian Post. The Guardian Post this Thursday morning focuses on Anglophone marginalization. The paper announces a stormy meeting between Northwest and Southwest traditional rulers, built for Monday, October 3 in Kumba, from Victor Mukete, president of the Southwest Chiefs Conference, SWEC, and from Teche Nje, president of the Northwest Funds Union, Noel will use this meeting to rethink joint strategies on how to push the Anglophone problem further. You can flip to page 3 for more information. Still on page 3 of the Guardian Post this morning, the paper says that the Minister of Sports and Physical Education, Bidung Pat, has justified rejected Women's African Cup of Nations budget that was slashed to less than 5 billion francs from the initial 23 billion francs earlier proposed by the local organizing committee. You might well want to read further on the minister's revelation in this newspaper. On to the Post newspaper. As October 1 draws near, the Post weekender on its big story focuses on the union between Southern Cameroons and French Cameroon. 55 years after the union, the paper notes that 55 years after independence and eventual reunification of the two territories, and the Anglophones are coming out as losers. Certain ministerial positions are Francophone reserved. An Anglophone can never be president, and some Anglophone structures have been deleted, leaving Anglophones to become SCNC, either active or passive. You will find in this package a compelling interview with the varsity don and political scientist, Dr. Willie Bot Zengwa, as he throws more light on the issue. You can flip to page 4 and 5 for more on this. Still on the Post weekend, the paper tells us that Bakosi chiefs have halted works on the Kumba Manfe Road over what they lament as the bad manner in which the road is being constructed by the Chinese contracting company. You might well want to read further on what transpired before these Bakosi chiefs, 14 in number, decided to stop works on the ongoing Kumba Manfe Road. You can go to page 3. Our next tabloid this morning is the Sun newspaper. The Sun this morning rises up with a groundbreaking innovation in the University of Boya, as the paper reports that DNA test is now done in the University of Boya. This test, the paper adds, will solve paternity and maternity disputes and also aid in criminal investigations. But researchers are lamenting that government is here to support the project. You can read further on this groundbreaking innovation out there in the University of Boya on page 2 of the Sun newspaper. Bia's mandate as a CPDM national chairman is intact, says the coordinator of the CPDM Academy, Professor Elvis Ngolengole, to the Sun newspaper. But how is that possible when the mandate of President Paul Biya as chairman of his party officially expired some weeks back? You will find out in the Sun newspaper. The paper also tells us, the paper also reports on the death of former Israeli Prime Minister and President Shimon Peres, who died earlier this week. Shimon Peres, as should be noted, was the last living founding father of the state of Israel back in 1948, and he will be buried in Jerusalem tomorrow, Friday. You can read further on this great man who impacted politics in the Middle East on page 10. Our last for today is a Scoop newspaper, the tabloid Scoop source on that the chairman of the SDF, John Fundi, was admitted at the Shisom Cardiac Center. But the chairman has rubbished reports, insisting that he is in excellent health. You can read further on this story, which continues to animate the press on page 4 of the Scoop. On page 6 of the Scoop, young people demand reparations for decades of neglect, despite the fact that the population is giving all their support to the ruling party, the CPDM. You might want to read the terms of this reparation demand inside the Scoop newspaper. In Bafut, the treasurer of the council plays with 15.5 million francs CFA. The who, what, when, and how of that Scoop on page 7. On the Scoop newspaper. That was all we had for the press outlook in the English language. We'll turn over to René Nassis Moto for what the French tabloids will be telling us this morning.